whatever I'm showing here is done in LaTeX using PDF LaTeX. So I can, after I show this, I can also show you how to draw and how I did this in LaTeX. Both the things I will be showing small durations of time. Okay, first I start up with the initial structures. The first thing is how to draw aliphatic hydrocarbons. Here I have drawn heptane and heptine. So I have used GChemPaint to draw all the structures. So this session is only how to explore the software to draw various structures. So you can try drawing along with me how I will draw this. So at the same duration, first I will show the presentation, then I will try to draw on the board with my own software. You can see and draw along with me. Okay, the second slide is shown about cyclic compounds, cyclopentane, hexane and benzene. Then we have alcohols, different types of alcohols are drawn from simpler alcohol, primary, then secondary, tertiary, 1,2-diene, glycerol, cyclohexane, all of them, 1,1-diene. Then we have heterocyclic compounds. All these are drawn using GChemPaint. And then some conversions, we can use propane and convert it into different structures. Conversion from propane. Propane is taken as initial structure and then it is converted to various other structures like diamine, ether, or aldehyde, or acetone, acetic acid, only from the basic structure propane. Then we have got ketoenol-tautomers. Again, we can draw using GChemPaint, various types of ketoenol-tautomers. And then the next very important part is we are into resonance structures. This is a very important part of GChemPaint, how to draw resonance structures using GChemPaint. We can draw various types of resonance structures using GChemPaint. All type of arrow-fitting, so addition of lone pair of electrons, movement of the arrow, and putting a positive charge, negative charge, moving the bond, all these things we can do. And then resonance structures of phenol, like benzene-like structures, we can do again. Electron movement we can show. Then this is the next very important feature of GChemPaint. We can convert the 2D structure which we have drawn in GChemPaint and convert it into 3D structures. Okay, here the first structure I have taken is a glucoside, and then I have taken the structure and then converted it. Okay, how I do this? We have a feature in GChemPaint which is called templates. So we can actually take the template, convert it into 3D structure. The template is already available, we don't have to draw it, it's available in the GChemPaint. After it is taken into the main window, we have to save it as .mol file, and then once it is converted into .mol file, you will have a 3D structure. Next is a different way to show. The first one is a cylindrical model, and the next one is space filling, CPK space filling. We were talking about this earlier also. We can convert the structure to the same structure I have made it into cylindrical and then CPK space filling. You all know what CPK space filling is, right? All of you are familiar with this word. We can space fill the structure. Then it is, there is one more GChemPaint feature in the GChem3D version. We have it. This particular structure I have drawn and I have rotated into good familiar correct orientation so that we can see all the bonds clearly. And then we can draw cycloalkanes. Here cyclohexane I have drawn, methyl cyclohexane, and some more entities, cyclopropane, all types. Chair and board forms, all of them we can draw. Okay, next is different forms of cyclohexane, board, chair, half chair, twist, and all those things. All these forms we are able to draw in GChemPaint. Then, bridge compounds, all of you are familiar with this too, I suppose, camphor and non-borate, we will be able to draw using GChemPaint. Then, there is one more very important feature, orbital overlap. And in this version of GChemPaint, I can draw only simple orbitals. I won't be able to draw mixing orbitals. I won't be able to draw just like SPPD, or I won't be able to draw mixed ones. I can draw pure orbitals like SP, SS, and P. I can do both type of bondings. I can do internuclear bonding, and I can also do cyclic overlapping in both of these. That is what I'm showing here. SS bonding, SP bonding, and PP bonding. Okay, then I go to geometrical isomers. Everybody is familiar with the structures, I suppose. Trans and cis forms of all the structures. We can clearly draw structures. We can rotate them also in GChemPaint. once we have drawn them in chicken feet, we can make them into chicken feet. We can rotate and see how exactly they look like. Next is, I hope everybody is familiar with this, Neumann projections. Very clearly we will be able to draw Neumann projections using chicken feet. And all the other forms, Hedwig's, Eclipse, Hand Staggered, Wash, all forms are easily drawn. But this particular activity is, it's not that easy. It took some time for me to draw. But then we are able to draw. And then we have optical isomers to be drawn. We have all these ones, bed bonding, hash, everything is available in chicken feet. So we can draw them, we can move the bond in different directions. Then next thing is RS. Okay, this particular structure I have drawn using higher version of chicken feet, that is 0.14, 0.18. The one which you are having, I have used that version to draw. In this version, we can see colored bonds. In the earlier version which I have, I do not have color, but here you can see the atoms are in color. Like ammonia part is colored, Br is colored, OH is colored. This is a new version of chicken feet where I can see the atoms in color. The earlier version which I have do not have colors. Then we can draw Fisher projections. Okay, this is Haber projections. Okay, the Haber projections are actually available in the templates menu. We can directly load the Haber projections from the templates menu, put them in GKP. Okay, after we draw the Haber projection, we can join by this glucosidic linkage also. We can do for two different Haber structures. Then, reaction. Okay, this is very, very important part. We can do reaction, draw reactions. Also, we can attach catalysts. That is, we can attach, like this, I have taken gravity-mer reaction. I have attached sodium hydroxide as a catalyst. We can attach it as a catalyst. If we move, it stays along with the arrow. And then we can also add H+, that is, if we move the reaction in acidic medium, it remains as H+. So the reaction, we can show different parts. Like the middle one is, which I contoured, is an intermediate. So, same we can do. Okay, the next thing is showing arrows in aniline. Is ionization reaction and then different form of arrow representation I am showing here. Okay, the next part is very familiar to all of you, coordination complexes. So also we can draw them here in chicken feet. Okay, this is GChem table. GChem table is one more feature of GChem paint. GChem paint actually is having three features along with the main GChem paint window, GChem 3D, GChem Calc and GChem table. Okay, GChem table is showing periodic table properties, like you can draw graphs between electronegativity, atomic number, or various types of graphs we can draw, and we can also show various properties of, like here there are different colors for each period, or suppose you have alkali metals in different color, alkaline earth in different, and full D block in different colors. We have family group of segregation in GChem paint. And this is one more feature of GChem paint. Here I am showing temperature point of view. It means that at absolute zero, all the substances are in solid state. They would look blue in color. But as I drag this particular arrow, now I am not able to drag now. I'll show when I drag. So, as we increase the temperature, the color will completely become red. Initially, all the color at absolute zero will be blue in color, indicating that it is a solid state. But slowly, as we increase the temperature, it will go to green color. Here also, you can see some green entities. That means they are in liquid state, and then we have finally red entities, all those are gases. So as we start increasing the temperature, as I drag this particular slider, the color will slowly change from blue to green and then to red. So when it comes to red, it means all of the substances are in gaseous state. Okay, that's all for this session.